Cult of Contempt podcast is brought to you by Bath & Body Works Cucumber Melon Lotion. If this guy can use it, then everybody should. Good evening and welcome to Cult of Contempt. The show will begin shortly as soon as we get transmission to space.
No!
In the meantime,
Peggy, of course I can't go swimming. You know I've got the curse.
Hey! Oh, Austin! Austin, stun the Donald!
What?
Coming soon on video and DVD.
What's up, Internet? I'm Sweet Jimmy Cook, and this is North Jersey.
Hey guys, Sweet Jimmy Cook, 6'8 Mathematics, celebrating their 15th anniversary. Come check them out with Quiz Show, The Outliers, and Sad About Girls. Paul Crane's gonna be there. I'm gonna be there. You gonna be there?
Toys, books, tapes and DVDs, antiquities, oddities, an embalmed horse. All at amazing prices. Necropolis, serving up everything from superheroes to the obscure. 59 Passaic Street, Garfield, New Jersey. Don't forget to visit the haunted basement for some spooky deals. Necropolis, 59 Passaic Street, Garfield, New Jersey. Patronize, if you dare.
Spaceship is very expensive.
Yeah, we're selling out. We got Tom from the 90s guys over.
Woo! Hey, we're on the subject. This is your second time on the show. I believe you were on episode 3. I'll have to check with the archivist. Lindsay, please let me know what episode that was.
No, Lindsay, tell us.
She used to work at archives, so she's an archivist. Anyway, this is a Cult of Contempt gift basket, gift bags, et cetera, et cetera.
I really enjoy the bag.
Yeah, I wanted to find something that looked like a My Little Pony's vagina.
My Little Pony, go
this
right
is like
in there.
The gayest moment I've had in September right here.
Yeah, how often do you get a bag from somebody that has their own logo on it?
I can say zero times.
I think that's a bag you could re-gift.
Well, what do I have here?
And he has.
I noticed you were dressed as Robin on your Facebook page.
Oh, nice.
Yes, I Facebook stalked you, but
nice.
It's in the bag. It's a Teen Titans toy, but you're a 90s guy. I believe that was a late 90s toy.
This is Teen Titans Go, which is
much later,
but I'll take it because it's right. Robin. So Robin, I guess the little disc flies off.
Yeah, it flies
okay.
off.
Okay. What else we got here? We got...
Oh, this is some stuff I
convinced
you. Yeah.
All right.
You gave me that,
What's
too.
Great is, once you're done with that, you can reuse that case to smuggle anything.
Like weed.
A joint? Your pills?
I don't do that.
For someone else. All right. Someone
well, what if you have heart meds? I mean,
you could
pills.
Smuggle
pills don't have to be
Mighty
illegal.
Max toys in that.
Nice.
So weird. I woke up this morning and I'm like, what am I going to do for Comic-Con this year? Kind of want to do Mighty Max. And it was the first time I thought of Mighty Max in years, and now you're just randomly mentioning it.
Wait, you go to, you go to San Diego Comic-Con?
New York Comic-Con.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Mighty Max is a good one. Are you going to dye your hair?
No, I got a wig.
Do you really?
I have a blonde wig for a Link costume I could reuse for a Mighty Max.
Oh, yeah, that's true. You just put that hat on?
Yeah.
What about the listeners who don't know what a Mighty Max is?
You're a good-looking dude. You should always have
fresh
breath.
Yeah, we should probably explain to our troglodyte listeners what Mighty Max is.
Mighty Max was in competition with Micro Machines for... Micro Machines was doing these playsets with the Star Wars property where you had tiny, tiny figures into transformable bases. The base was the transformer, not the figures. The figures were just these incidental pre-posed figures. But Mighty Max got into the game, and then Marvel got into the game with their danger, with their...
You know what came first
Pocket
before
comic
that? Polly Pocket was, like,
true.
The inceptor of that.
Yeah. And like, we need a boy version.
Yeah, we should make a boy version of this.
They always rob Peter to pay Paul in 20th year. I'll tell you a great story. Masters of the Universe line, the second He-Man and Skeletor had that effect where if you hit him in the chest, the thing would...
Oh, yeah.
That was from a Hot Wheels line.
Was
it
really?
An effect, like a... It was a
car
that would get damaged.
Oh,
yeah. So they're like, hey, why don't we use that for this? And
fuck it. Stick it on He-Man's chest.
I had Hot Wheels that had the car damage thing on it.
Yeah, it's great.
And
it's
I think
great.
I had one of those, the Ewok set. I think I had an Ewok face that turned into the,
yeah,
to the...
There was definitely tiny Star Wars toys like that. I think I gave you one of the ones I had.
No, they didn't have a face effect. You gave me
one of the little tiny
figures.
You gave me a Danger Room pocket comic from Marvel and Toy Biz at the time.
No, I gave you another one too. That was a real tiny
you gave me a
little Star
yeah.
Wars.
Yes.
No, a real tiny little Star Wars too. I think like a long time ago. I'm pretty sure.
I've seen those, the tiny Star Wars.
I know what you're talking about.
They were super.
That's
little.
Where I got that from. Oh, it's been in the pile of I don't know what to do with this.
Yeah, it's like a kind of an odd thing, but Star Wars is going to be pretty big.
Yeah.
It's going to be going to be. It already is.
I know, but that new movie's coming out. You're going to capitalize.
Yeah, I have 3 movie posters in reserve. I have 5 action figures, 2 carded. I probably shouldn't have gave Kylo Ren to the listeners, but I did at the Cult of Contempt salute to the Clash Bar.
Cult of Contempt, salute to the Clash Bar. It was a good time.
It was a good time.
Excellent time.
We should have just called the whole thing Divine Intervention.
Yeah. We had our friend dress up as Divine, who's like a cult figure from like John Waters movies. It's a dude that was like dressed as a chick and drag and ate human shit on film.
It was a gag.
Yeah, these are
literally a gag because if you eat human shit, you're probably gagging.
Yeah.
It's
I actually made fake poop for Santos to eat. I thought the footage was crass, so
fake
it was
poop.
The open.
Footage was crap? Okay.
But it was kind of funny. I made fake poop.
Shit,
out of
fake poop. I made real poop.
I make real poop every day, Paul. You're not so special, honey.
Everybody poops.
Except you.
Thanks for telling me my breath stinks.
No, bedside. If you want to have morning sex with your partner, you pop one of those in instead of the, your breath stinks, go brush your teeth, and then it delays everything.
I just always just bang the girl from behind.
Yeah.
I don't want to smell her breath either.
Yeah, just the spooning kind of move.
I know that was for funsies, but there's some Apple.
Is there a
farms
coupon in there for a back rub?
Who likes skinny peanut butter?
There's the Applegate Farms is an organic bacon thing.
Is there a coupon in there for gay conversion therapy? Because I think you need it, Jim Cook.
Wait, are you guys accusing me of being gay?
Are you like giving like swag to everybody who comes on the show more than once?
Yeah.
Well, all I know is
we gave Santos an entire evening for coming on the show 3
Santos
times.
Is like the fifth Beatle, man.
But
all I know is I can get.
I'm not saying that you
a dollar off of bacon now, so
nice.
I'm happy.
Nice.
Yeah. And then,
bacon.
The bang. Peanut butter thinks there's a natural one that's the numbers aren't so bad. If you want to carve cheap.
You're eating bacon, you don't care about the numbers.
Well, no, I was talking about the Skippy.
I don't even cook that shit. I just eat it raw. I ball it up like an apple.
Bacon?
Oh, yeah. I just make a bacon ball. I don't even fucking cook it. I'll just eat raw bacon like an apple at work. It's really off-putting.
I have respect enough for bacon to not do that.
I think Paul should make like the next gift bag, and they'll just be like razor blades and raw bacon.
And trails.
You have to guess what animal it is.
Yeah, just keep
holding animal.
Close your eyes and put your hand in the bag.
Is that animal grease on the bottom of this bag? What is that? A liver?
This show's been officially derailed. There's two announcements I'd like to make before we get to
Backyard Wrestling. Yeah, why don't you give me a fucking address?
What's that? All right. So first off, happy birthday to Beefcake Terry on the 2nd, and happy birthday to Alana Cortuccio Bonillo, lead singer of 68 Mathematics.
Happy birthday to my friend Joe.
I forgot to put the address there at Tierney's. I don't know the address, but go to Tierney's in Montclair on the internets. You'll find it. It's the 13th, Friday the 13th. Which is a day I'm doing a corporate gig for a buddy of mine's company, Picnic, where I'm doing Deal or No Deal to give out the prizes.
Mm-hmm.
Talk about my
Deal or No Deal on one of the most unlucky days of the year.
Right?
Exactly.
I like it.
It's crazy.
It is crazy.
I've never actually seen that game show, so I have to actually phone up and
You have to watch Regis.
Yeah. Not Who Wants to Be a Millionaire, Deal or No Deal.
With
Howie Mandel in the suitcase.
Oh, that was Howie Mandel, the bald guy?
Yeah.
That doesn't like to touch anybody?
Yeah.
I think it's Wayne Brady right now.
Even better.
Somebody's doing it different. I don't remember.
I have to look.
I'm probably completely wrong.
Anyway, to get the gig, I had to send them a demo, and they didn't see enough of me emceeing to do the demo, and I didn't have much footage. So I had was Aunt Alana's wedding, and I had the Santos event. So my friend, I don't know if he wants us to tell his name, but my friend said that it was run by this woman named Mrs. Rosenberg, who's old and Jewish. And I thought, okay, she's old and Jewish. She must love Mel Brooks. Mel Brooks was in vaudeville. Vaudevillians used to do drag on a regular basis. I think this will go over well. And so what I heard...
That's always the logical conclusion I jump to when I hear someone is Jewish.
That'd be okay.
Jewish, ergo, I need to dress in drag.
You don't understand. Like, there's this one woman I work with at the demos at the ShopRites. I forget her name offhand, but she's this old blonde, but she jokes, like, and she's got a filthy freaking mouth like
hilarious.
A trucker.
Yeah,
oh, my God. So I was like, they'd be okay with this. But the woman in the board meeting said, what is wrong with that woman? Is she okay? I'm like, oh, poor fucking Santos. So I posted on, after I got the gig, I posted the drag thing. I never thought that would get me a gig. Like, this is great. And then it turned out my friend kind of had to do some maneuvering to keep me on. So
I think in the future...
He's not bringing that girl, is he?
They have to have a Cult of Contempt drag show.
Oh, God, no.
I think that's going to happen.
Why? Why is that going to happen?
He can dress in drag, and so can Santos.
And so could I. And I would look better than fucking most of the women. But why?
I doubt it.
Why? I would make a beautiful woman. Girl, would tell me that all the time.
I would have
very soft features.
I would have made a sexy chick.
Exactly.
Mallrats reference? No? Okay.
I just think that the standard local show is not good enough anymore. I think we need to up the
ante. We need to be like the club kids in the 90s and start fucking really upping the craziness factor.
Yeah.
That's what we did.
But not with a drag show. We just have to throw themes. Like, people like a themed silly thing. Not to mock themes, but... You know, it's fucking Miami Vice. We're all doing Miami Vice. Everybody's got to do Miami Vice.
Wow.
You know, everyone's going to be there in their fucking, their blazers.
What would
be
funny is if Leray dressed like Crockett, not Tubbs.
I got a good one.
A-Team.
Weird Al.
Weird Al.
Everyone just dresses up like Weird Al.
Or a Weird Al character.
Or, yeah.
Or you could just show up as a Dr. Demento in a tuxedo and a top hat.
Dallas.
Fuck that.
We're gonna have a Dallas night.
Yeah?
I'm gonna dress like Patrick Duffy.
I'm gonna wear a 10-gallon hat in here?
Yeah, I'm gonna wear a 10-gallon hat.
I would have to be like Boss Hogg. We should be like fucking...
You can't do that.
Dukes of Hazzard.
You can't do Dukes of Hazzard. It's not allowed. There's a Confederate flag on the car.
Well, we don't have to do the car.
Yeah, but how do you do Dukes of Hazzard without the car?
Put a Union flag on the car. It's our flag.
Well, I like that.
We should make up a new flag to put on the Dukes of Hazzard car.
Just a middle finger.
So that they can CG it onto all the old episodes. It should just be like a spread eagle, like a woman, a woman's vagina.
But it has to, she has to be like
penis and balls
she has to
under
be like,
it.
She has to be like this, though, so it looks
that's
like
more acceptable than a Confederate flag. Like, yeah, we're just gonna show full frontal nudity on the front of this fucking car.
Full frontal trans nudity brought to you by Cult of Contempt.
Yeah, we should buy the rights to Dukes of Hazzard. You know what we have the rights to?
What's that?
Is a great backyard wrestling video that I've dug up from the archives. I've rewired everything so I can put it on the TV here for you guys.
Nice segue, by the way.
And
yeah, that was really well done.
And you'll also be seeing it on the screen. So,
our little man.
It's on a VHS.
It's on a real VHS tape. Tom just saw me. Hex. Oh, here you go. NWF, the Nutley Wrestling Federation.
Hell,
you guys ready? Draven Unleashed.
Ooh,
it's coming. I made those computer graphics on my computer.
Well done.
Thanks.
They were legible. I don't even know what that said.
Oh, yeah.
Draven, Pegasus Kid, Best of Five Falls.
Five Falls.
Nutley Guido in a hardcore match.
Not yet.
Oh, and there's an interview after, which I don't think is actually...
Static and glitches. I didn't know those were words.
Oh, here we go. Yeah. The action's about to begin.
Nice.
This is my grandparents' house.
This is his grandparents' house.
That's hilarious.
All right, so who am I looking at right now?
Right now, so that's Unforgiven.
Yeah, he was like our Kane, like kind of our Kane character, if you know who Kane is.
That's
like,
Draven. Yeah. The good old Draven.
And that's me right there with my son in.
Nice.
Here we go. We lock.
Oh, there we go.
Oh, I took him down, but he knows something.
That might be me on the ground.
You know
what's
funny? The whole first 20 minutes of the show, you were questioning my sexuality. Look at your hair, Jesus.
Oh, I know. Oh, nice move.
Wow, these guys actually did the moves.
Yeah, look at that. We did. I did a suplex.
That was
when he knows sells it. He gets right up. I still have that trench coat somewhere. Kick that in his face.
Nice.
Did you guys choreograph stuff to begin with, or you just
kind of... A lot of the time, we would think about it, but we would call it in the ring. We had no referee here, obviously.
Because I'm usually the ref. I don't know where I am.
You might... We never made you the camera guy, did we?
No.
Oh,
well, yeah.
Look at these aggressive kicks.
Yeah, that one. Oh, you used to stiff everyone. You're the stiff master. You're just like, ugh.
You know, I gotta be honest. I was kind of dreading this show, but I laughed four times already.
This is fucking
crazy. Wait, this is the best. This is the best. There are no actual ropes. Oh, I thought you were going to throw him against the ropes.
No, I don't throw him against the ropes.
What, do you make him smell his belt?
I just hit him in the face with it, and then he just gets up. All he does in this match is just get hit with stuff and then get up. And I don't know what to do.
Get
better. And then he just beats the shit out of me.
Nice.
That hurt. I remember that hurting.
Weren't you not supposed to wrestle this night?
No, I was allowed to wrestle. I didn't have mono at this point.
No?
At one point, I had mono while I did this. Look at those aggressive shots. There's commentary. I don't think they can
hear
it.
Who's doing the voiceover?
That's...
Is that you?
No, it's my brother and my cousin.
Wait, who's the guy laying over there?
That's my brother. That's the Nutley Guido character, I believe, right now. Yeah.
Yeah, he's the Nutley Guido.
He's just Nick.
So there was the Nutley Guido, there was Cugino.
Everybody had at least, like, two characters. So that's
here you go, off the ropes.
There
no
go.
Ropes.
So that was Unforgiven's secondary character, my brother Danny. His first character is Pegasus Kid, which is like a Triple H ripoff.
He's in the next match.
But why is he just laying there? Is that like
he got knocked out?
He got knocked out before the match. His character was like a joke because we just needed a guy that would lose.
Dude, these guys are constantly
here we go.
Professional.
We put these tables like this to make like an entrance. Like that was our entrance. It's like a fucking grapevine on top. And then here we are, we're backstage.
Phil must be using the camera.
Oh my god. I love the chaos that you guys went backstage.
Yeah, we're backstage. Look at all the people. I choke him with a fucking rake.
Nice.
It's a mop.
It looks like Kylo Ren.
Yeah, it does.
Look at that.
Okay, so it's an actual cane mask that we painted black.
Oh, yeah?
But I don't know. I don't remember him ever wearing the ski mask on top.
I don't think it was even a cane mask. I think it was like a weird sci-fi
mask. No, it was a cane mask. It was when he first came out with the...
Punk rock baby will make our dream come true. Look at the baby face right there.
He put a garbage can on me. I did not agree to that.
That's hilarious.
And then he hit it with this thing. And I just stand there like an asshole because I don't know what to fall into. Yeah, I didn't know where to fall. So I was like, I'm on concrete.
Stand there.
So I'll just stand there. I'm going to get run into this thing right now. That hurt. That's not me faking it. That's me really holding my head because that hurt.
Nice.
I get the fuck choked out of me here.
Wow, this is a grade A, class A camera work
this
here.
This must have been the first Unforgiven then, because that was, I don't remember this mask at all.
That's a plastic mask.
That's
bag.
A plastic
he just
bag.
Fucking, yeah, like
I'm
he just cut holes in
a
plastic bag.
Nice.
Oh, here we go, off the ropes into a bush. Against the hood of a car. Oh!
Nice.
Against the fence.
I miss this so much, though.
This is fantastic.
It's fucking hilarious.
You guys should do this again at our age now.
That's it. I was talking to Dan the other day. I'm like, we should make a documentary about this because we have so much footage. We probably have hours and hours. Dude, this is what we were doing on 9/11. It was like, TV is fucking just all the same shit.
Oh, yeah,
like,
that's true.
Let's go backyard wrestle. Like, yeah. Okay. That's what I did on 9/11. I backyard wrestled.
Well, yeah, there's something. Taking my own.
What year was this?
I don't know, 2000.
You guys use the most dangerous weapons. I mean, a crutch, a broom, garbage.
Oh, back to the ring. And a fucking, I don't know what that was. That
how
was
did
that.
You learn to do the moves? You just guys fucked around until you figured it out?
We just
what?
Watched yeah. it on TV.
That's pretty cool. Nice.
Yeah, that suplex you did in the right. beginning was pretty good.
Yeah, it was pretty good. This
yeah.
boss is pretty good too.
Wait till I drop him on his fucking head in the next match. It's like the most like horrifying. And the next match too, I would say, has much better camera work. This has to be Phil.
I don't think it could be me because it would be a lot lower on the walking shots.
Yeah, I don't think it was ever you. I don't ever remember
it was
you.
Me. It had to have been me once because remember the time the lightning storm came and I went in to turn the.
You were the referee.
The computers off. Was I referee at that time?
You were the referee. That's why we were like, fucking, where the fuck is he going? Mom told me to turn off the microwave if it starts... I don't know, or the computer. The computer. Mom told me to turn off the computer if it starts to thunder and lightning. And then his brother fucking goes in the house and, like, grabs him and, like, starts, like, hitting him and, like, brings him back out to the ring and makes him fucking count.
Nice.
Fuck what Mom told you to do.
What were your grandparents saying? Like,
my grandparents were the owners of.
They would come out and do like promos.
Yeah, awesome.
Yeah, it was fucking great. His grandma and grandpa, like, they were like Vince McMahon and like Linda McMahon, like they would come out like, oh, you're fired. Like, I was like 80 years old, standing there like getting in the guy's face. Like,
he just randomly threw.
He just drops me onto him. Yeah, like a dick. There's something else that hurt in this match. I forget what it was, but I think it's coming.
I think we need some of the other characters from this on this show.
Unfortunately, I'm not here.
Not yet.
I'm on this?
You're on this. Yeah, you're in the last match.
Last match? Oh, man.
But we can fast forward through a lot of the next one. I'll tell you, it's... Oh, look at that. That really hurt.
Where'd you guys get the road sign?
We stole it.
No, I bought it at a yard sale. I would never... There was definitely something else in this match I think that hurt. Oh, he comes back to life.
Oh, shit.
Oh, no. I got basically a 5 count against me. This is my best of tape, okay? I lost that match. Here you go.
Right, this is my backyard now.
Yeah, now this is his backyard.
Nice.
Oh, here you go, the commentary too, it's great. Bouncing around the ropes, drinking my water.
my sonnen.
Look how young you are.
Yeah, I know.
I just want to smack your little face and tell you to do your homework.
Backyard wrestle.
Oh, how could you hate this? This is pure entertainment right here.
Pure gold.
Gold. I would never show this to anybody if I didn't have a podcast. Like, nobody would ever know about this. Like, I found a tub of VHS tapes, and,
is that what this is? Is there more wrestling shit here?
There's no more wrestling shit.
It's all wrestling.
That's the same guy I wrestled before, but now he's his, like, good guy character, Pegasus Kid.
Are you the same character you were when you fought into the other thing?
Yeah, I'm always the same character.
What is your character? Can you tell me a little bit about
I'm just like an angry misanthrope that likes to hit people with weapons.
A raven knockoff.
So you put no creativity into your character?
No, at all. Oh no, here comes another guy now. Here comes Dusk. Carrying a chair, the wrong kind of chair, but he's not gonna hit somebody, he's gonna sit on it. And then he talks for fucking 20 years.
Oh, he's
like one of the heels. You better win this match. The best part in this match is when I pick up a steel bar at one point, and he's like, what are you doing, you fucking idiot? Like, you hear him just say that to me, like, what am I gonna do to my friend in his backyard with a steel bar? Like, why did I grab this? Oh, I attacked him from behind.
So the guy that was talking, Dusk, that's my cousin. It's my cousin Phil.
The cousin of cousins. Oh, look at this rest hold. I'm just resting here. Off the ropes. No ropes. Oh, look at that aggressive clothesline. I hit him really hard there.
He's stumbling.
Now I stole this spot from Doink the Clown.
Nice.
Where I'm like faking him out, and then I'm not really faking anybody out. Test of strength.
Oh, that's not good.
Oh no, I'm winning. Look at my biceps, how big they are. And then like a really slow kick to them. And a pose.
Nice.
We thought we were gonna bang the neighbor that lived in that yard that you can see right now.
What was his name?
Her name. I don't remember, but she was smoking hot. And we thought we were gonna fuck her.
How old are you here?
Yeah, what are you, 16?
15, 16, yes.
I don't know. You thought you were going to fuck the neighbor woman, because at that point...
I don't even know if I was driving yet. I know I wasn't doing drugs yet, obviously.
Well, your son is my drug, yo.
Boom!
The other character was named O'Doul, and he drank O'Doul.
I was really hoping to see Nightmare Freddy get beat up.
I don't have any Nightmare Freddy footage.
But I did Nightmare Freddy once.
I think I did it twice. The mask was too hot in August.
Yeah.
Oh!
You suffer for your art. It's me in suits in August.
Oh, watch. Off the ropes. No ropes.
Where'd you guys get the canned crab?
The internet.
Really?
They weren't really there, as you could see.
No. Every
match was an empty arena match.
I was just curious because it was a little... It sounds a little tinny, but that might just be the VHS.
The worst hip toss ever! That was horrible.
I just want to see a picture of just a disapproving housewife across the street just shaking her head.
Yeah. And then the camera goes into her, she's like, I'm not fucking any of that. Oh, the cops.
Someone's...
I want none of this nonsense near me.
Someone's getting hurt.
Should be like a fuck your dad, maybe.
Watch, I do it again, guys.
Nice.
Hey, that was pretty good.
No, it's no good, because I'm supposed to bring him all the way up and then bring him back and fall flat.
It's a step suplex.
You're 16 and you're on a mattress with this guy ogling.
With another physical specimen. And we're combating.
So who's that? So what's the...
He's got like every belt. I had Ken Shamrock's ankle lock.
Nice.
Yeah. Except for the fact that I'm putting the pressure the wrong way, which probably hurt more. He was never the same again.
That's why my brother can't walk?
He's still selling it.
He's in the prepubescent play-by-play.
Oh, Alan, I think he was the oldest one.
Yes.
There was an ankle lock.
Oh my goodness, it's an ankle lock!
It's Mickey Mouse that's doing the front attack.
Oh!
Oh! His leg never got fully stretched down.
Dead on the ground! Ha ha!
Dead. Dead.
He's playing possum.
Is Pegasus Kid gonna finish me off? This is a best of five falls match.
Oh, you have to pin him five times?
No, one fall, I have to fucking count to 10 while he's on the ground. Another fall is a three fall. I think another one was submission. It was like the stupidest rules, and then the last one is a ladder. Or a ladder comes out, but I don't know if it was a ladder or what.
More of a step stool.
Step ladder.
Yeah, that
was your finisher, wasn't it?
Probably, but then I decided to do the rings of Saturn.
What
did you say?
What is Paul's character?
DDT? The Even Flow? DDT?
Draven,
yeah, like that guy from The Crow.
Yeah.
The Crow was real big, you know?
That's all it is.
Oh, he pins me.
We probably got a crow's hat, too. I think he regrets
it. Oh, and he wins. The first time, the first pinfall attempt, he beats me. This is my best of. I lose six times on it.
You're like the bad guy in everyone, so of course, right?
I don't know if I was a bad guy. I think I was somewhere in between.
I like when the bad guy wins, actually.
He comes out and yells at me and tells me to do stuff. I don't know. I'm tired here.
Get him, Pegasus Kid.
You can see as I walk away, I'm tired.
You can see by the way he fights, he's got a heart of gold.
Dan?
Yeah.
Right into his own chair.
Surprised it didn't break.
I'll hit him with a bat. Yeah, I love that. I go to town with a bat, and he focuses on him. I'm hitting...
Well, he is the champion.
I'm hitting Dan with a bat here. But it's like, let's focus on the guy on the ground. That's a real bat for whiffling.
Right.
Beat on the butt.
This is...
$1.69, your little 7-Eleven.
This is entertainment at its finest.
I'm entertained.
Here you go, I take the belt now.
I can't believe this.
I can't believe this. Yeah, we have Jim Ross and Jerry Lawler on commentary. I missed them, I think.
What was that?
And then I ran off the road.
That was terrible.
He did sweet chin music to my balls.
So weak.
He does that again, too. It's great. There's one part where he grabs my face, and I'm like, oh, he's definitely going to kick me in the face. No, he kicks me, like, in the legs. Thank God. That hurt.
Oh, jeez. Wait, so you were in cahoots with the cousin?
Apparently. Well, for now, I was. That was the best when he smacks him with it, like, real hard. Like, he fucking whacked him. He's really... Oh, yeah, and then I wiped the spit off on him, or somebody does, because somebody spit on it, I think. He spit on it before, yeah. Here you go. He goes, what are you doing, you fucking idiot, when I pick up a metal bar? I don't know what I thought I was going to do, like the Terminator. Like stick it through his back. Oh, here you go.
Nice.
Oh, yeah, let me put it on right. What, is he gonna tap out? Is he gonna tap out, guys?
You won't
do it. Fall?
Yeah.
You fell.
Yeah, I fell.
Nice.
It's great.
Just watching him hit Matt.
Oh, yeah.
They're standing on mattresses.
He couldn't be the referee, but he had to be there with the belts. In a match that's not about him.
It's just taunting with the belt.
Yeah. He was like Triple H, kind of.
Here, hit him with this one. It's plastic.
This will do more damage. Yeah, this is a match, but like, no. It's basically like we just made it up on the spot.
No, this was really well thought out. Like,
yeah, no,
level.
We thought out absolutely none of this. It was like
choreography.
Shit, yeah. We're in the yard. What is there? Oh, there's a metal pipe right here. Let me get that. Like. I don't know, help me.
It's like Crouching Tiger.
We talked to each other throughout it, like, you know, okay, now I'm gonna win, like, stuff like that.
Yeah. Alright, let's just do the ending. No, not yet. Oh, it's gonna happen.
What the hell is that? Oh, wait, that is you. Oh, okay. Wait, that got weird for sure.
Are your fingers all taped up?
Yeah. I taped that shit. This hurts.
Nice.
No, that wasn't nice. That hurt like all hell because I didn't jump right. And then he just muscled me up and just threw me down to the ground.
Nice.
Which was easy to do. We did every move to him because he was fucking like this big.
Yeah.
So we just like lift him up over our head like gorilla press. He's like, ah! My brother never wanted to do it because somebody's gonna get hurt.
I love doing this shit. This was so fun for me.
Oh yeah, right into the ribs. Oh. Here you go. This is where he grabs my face, I think. Oh no, it's not. He just throws me down like garbage. Like garbage. In the middle of the ring.
Garbage.
His dad would really rather we not climb on the deck.
Right.
But later in the match, we definitely ignore that and climb on the deck. There used to be a tree right there.
Yeah.
That's why that big red thing is there, to cover the stump. Nobody wanted to hit the stump.
No, you trip over that, right?
I remember my friend Adam was sitting on there once, and my dog Bailey went over and peed through the deck on him.
Oh, that was the Jake the Snake move, right?
DDT. Oh, I need him right in the balls there, too. That was funny. Oh, I won. This is my one win of this fucking thing, of this whole tank.
Wow. Congratulations, bro. We're
Thanks.
So proud of you.
Nice.
I feel really, God, what I would give to see that belt again.
What was the worst injury you guys had doing these things?
Tom, what was the worst injury you got?
Doing it?
I don't think any of us ever really got badly hurt.
I don't think I ever got hurt either.
That's good.
Everything was done on mattresses that we found in other people's lawns. Like,
right. You know, it's funny, though, because I remember seeing some crazy backyard wrestling on the internet over the years.
For
and
sure.
It's just like guys just doing shit they shouldn't be doing, like jumping through plywood and shit. But, like, you guys seem to be at least somewhat
organized. Well, we didn't want to get hurt because we didn't want to deal with my mother.
Sure.
Yeah. And we didn't
right.
We didn't have the things laying around that we could just destroy, you know? None of us had, like, a good paying job to buy random-ass tables and stuff.
Right.
Yeah.
I didn't have a job. I was too young.
Right.
Yeah, there was no child.
Get a paper out, kid.
Yeah.
I guess that job doesn't exist anymore.
No, his friend, like, wrestled when we were kids. So he, like, was in a ring before and, like, actually...
Like, once.
Yeah, but even still, it's like, he kind of learned, like, shit from his friend that was, like, how to, like, pull punches, how to do this, how to do that. So, like, he kind of showed us, like, the basics. Like, yeah, this is a hip toss. I didn't learn it, as you could have seen before. Where I take a hip toss and almost break my fucking neck. Like, the most rudimentary move. Yeah, this is where he grabs my face and I think he's gonna kick it.
Oh man, they're about to snuff the rooster.
Yeah.
I love the hair.
Oh, he ain't gonna die.
Hey, John. Yeah, his character from now on is the rooster.
Oh, God.
The rooster!
Hey, that's pretty good.
Oh,
so that's
that.
Your brother.
Pegasus Kid is my brother, yeah.
What's his first name?
Dan.
He's actually pretty good.
Yeah, he's probably the biggest wrestling fan of all of us.
But he, his acting is pretty good.
He's a natural actor, man.
Yeah.
Of all the people, like, when we were kids and we were always making movies and shit, like... He can play.
You just kicked him right in the nuts.
Nice. Drop kick, yeah, right to the nuts. But he was like, he always reminded me of like Michael Keaton when we were like kids, and like he was always acting like with his eyebrows.
Remember the duel video between Hannah?
Yeah,
that's on YouTube.
I saw that. We should play that too.
And remember the Daydream Believer one?
Yes.
I just recently reposted that on my channel.
I saw that. I commented on that. We did a Daydream Believer video on our kids. We had like a green screen. You can find it. What's your channel on?
So go to the 90s guys and search up a video called Dream a Little Dream. Basically the premise of it was before I knew what drugs were, I was getting high. And the whole thing is just me being high with in front of a green screen to, like, Daydream Believer. Yeah.
Basically, what we did was, like, make him mime playing Daydream Believer and, like, sing it. He's, like, fucking real, like, into it.
How'd you get him high? What'd you do?
No, we didn't get him high. None of us really... me and my friend saw Half-Baked, okay? So we're like, oh... we should fucking make, like, a video of, like, yeah, well... The same year, I think, it was, like... we had, like, we all crashed at his house on, like, New Year's. We were, like, little kids. And, like, him and my brother fell asleep. So we took fucking, like, cigarettes and, like, put it in our mouths. And, like, took empty fucking bottles and, like, put it in our hands. Like, made him hugging, like, a bottle of wine.
We were a lot younger at that point. I was... during the Dream a Little Dream video, I was in seventh grade.
Oh, you were that old? Okay. Yeah. Yeah, when they were really little, we, like, put, like, fucking cigarettes hanging out of their mouths and shit, like, for holding bottles, and we snap pictures, and then, like, sent the film to get developed in our house.
And you still want to show up to this guy's house. That's really cool. Good times, though.
I don't think I enjoyed the pictures once I saw them, but nowadays, it's awesome.
We did dumb shit, too. Like, we would never steal a beer from his parents or anything like that. Like, there was, like, always a fridge full of beer in the basement. It's like, whatever. Like, one time we're shooting a fucking me and Dan are downstairs. We're like, oh, let's make a beer commercial. Like, okay. So Dan fucking cracks a beer, takes a sip for the commercial, and puts it back in the fridge and says nothing to anybody. Not, I opened a beer to this commercial, not anything. So his parents see it. They're like, Alan, they ask his older brother, like, did you open a beer and take like one sip and then just put it back in the fridge? Why is there an open beer in the fridge? Like, that's really weird, you know?
And it's like, who's wasting fucking beer?
Yeah, really. And it's like, no, it was us. Like, oh, we were shooting a commercial. Coors Light called. They needed our help.
Well, I mean, I guess it's refreshing to know that, like, it wasn't like it was a finished beer that was, you know, finished and the can was crushed and hidden behind the
house. No, we just left it there.
So it wasn't like you were hiding anything.
But for this video with the Daydream Believer, we were like, yeah, take this thing and, like, just pretend it's like a cigarette. Like, we just gave him, like, a rolled-up piece of paper, and it's, like, shows, like...
So he was, like, pretend high.
Yeah, the whole time, he's just playing fucking Daydream Believer on a piano, like... I don't know.
I gotta see this.
And like, there's,
it's on 90s guys?
Yeah, 90s guys. Fucking hilarious.
It's called Dream a Little Dream.
Oh, look at this.
Got flagged for copyright because the actual song's in it.
Yeah. We didn't give a fuck, though. When we were kids.
Is it still up now, even though the song?
Yeah, it just can't be monetized. Not that I can be monetized on that channel anymore. I used to be, and then they changed the rules, and now I don't get money on that.
Yeah, I don't get money on mine either.
That sucks.
Not like we did much. I think we had like $9 over 2 years.
Yeah.
Are they going to try to cut in to the Patreon money? You think YouTube's going to be dicks like that? Can they?
I don't think they can. It's like, you can put whatever you want on YouTube, so if you want to advertise your Patreon, that's within your realm, unless they start like, no more Patreon, we're just taking anybody who has a Patreon off, they'd have fucking nobody.
Because that seems to be the way to go.
Always plug your Patreons.
Yeah.
Oh,
I
don't know.
I keep thinking about launching a Patreon, but I never do it. I'm like,
I think you did already for this show.
No, I've been kicking it around. I wrote
you
all
posted
copies.
A thing on Facebook that you were doing.
I'm thinking about it. I'm still mulling it over. I'm still trying to figure out my price points and like what I want to give. Because it can't just be for the show and it can't just be for the music. It's got to be, oh, Kanahaja Main. Look at his eyebrows. He's selling that.
Yeah, he is.
I definitely see the resemblance with you two.
Yeah, when he was younger.
Does he tan more than you, or is that just the video?
It's just the video.
That's the whole family.
Yeah, yeah.
Me and his older brother had a... we were a cornhole team. called it sounds a lot dirtier than it is.
Called but. Brown and Beautiful.
Oh, that's my. That was my tie-dye chair.
Your tie-dye chair?
No, that was your. Whose was that? Because I had that in high school. So where did that come from?
That might have come from my house. I remember having one of those. That, like, little foam tie-dye chair. Was that what
it was? Dave's? Did Dave give that to me?
He might have, yeah.
Dave may have given that to me.
I remember the fucking, you had the Mario one that got ripped up by a squirrel.
Oh, yeah.
They had a squirrel in their basement, just, like, wreaked havoc. It's like, no, we can't go down there and get toys anymore. Like, there's a squirrel down there.
What are you doing here? It looks like you tried to
get
the
four.
Fatal four, the...
I lived in a garden apartment.
It was so wrong.
In Lake Hiawatha. And I saw fucking squirrel teeth coming through the fucking bathroom while I was fucking taking a shower in New York. It was the scariest fucking shit.
Figure four. Figure four. That's what that was.
That was not the figure four.
That was the figure eight.
No, figure eight is actual move.
Here you go, stiff kicks.
Nice.
Oh, I went down low instead of kicking.
Swept the leg.
Yeah, I swept the leg instead of the head.
Sweep the leg, Johnny.
That's a good move, sweep the leg.
Yeah.
No, this is really like, I don't know, I still think that I could wrestle today, but it's like, no, I wouldn't last 5 seconds running around. Oh, I made up my own submissions sometimes.
Oh, that's pretty good.
Yeah, where I would just like twist and turn people. Oh, that was the mic.
Nice.
That highlighter.
Oh, he's shoving a highlighter in his face. Smell it. Smell it.
You're going to be yellow now.
We made fake ones after a while, didn't we? We got like...
We had one that wasn't actually a mic. It just was a mic, like, prop.
Yeah.
Man, that's wrong.
It had like a... It was like the child's mic that you could, like, talk into, but it really just had, like, springs inside of it or whatever.
Oh, yeah.
It's
voice echo.
Oh, I knew you were talking. Yeah, I've seen those.
Wouldn't let him get the criminal.
No, fuck that. He ain't getting that on me. I almost paralyze him soon.
Well, I do have to say, Paul, that you know how you give certain bands shit for, like, their songs being really long without a lot of hooks?
Yeah.
This match should have just been one fall.
No, we had
it
to do
seems like it's
you're
forever beating on the Pegasus Kid.
No, the Pegasus Kid's forever beating on me.
Like, I don't even know what fall we're on right now.
I think it's the third.
I lost track after, what was the first one? A one, that's right. Yeah. Smell them.
It almost looks like sexual harassment.
I'm pretty sure we used a highlighter as if.
I know, really.
Mike.
Was it a good marker? Like, would you get high a little bit?
Probably not.
So
like,
yeah, what did
not
you
like
do
a literal highlighter.
They actually
there is a ladder. You did
there's a ladder. I had to get to the ladder part.
It was only
about
2 steps of it.
Yeah, you could have jumped
so
that.
So you
could have
jumped that. What were you saying?
You said that you got high and didn't know it or something like that?
No,
you
didn't get high.
That video, I pretended to be high, but before I really knew what drugs were, so I was like,
the way you worded that sentence confused us with men, because we thought you, like, got roofied or something. Like, our generation thinks the worst.
I acted being high before I knew what anything...
Oh, look at that! I fail miserably at my move. I almost paralyzed Dan real soon. Yeah, he has to do the move that I just failed to do.
Oh!
To me.
Is it the stratisfaction?
No, that's the acid drop. Well, I guess maybe it's the same move. I don't know.
Are these moves like the same moves you see in wrestling shows? You guys
but just performed much worse than I would see them at any wrestling show.
Think of them as a wrestling cover band.
Gotcha.
Yeah, it's like a wrestling cover band that, like, should have never left
the
garage.
What belt was this for? Was this for Dusk's belt? Because
I don't know. It doesn't make any sense.
I don't know. There's some talent here.
We just rigged up this thing. Oh, here you go. Powerbomb.
The worst powerbomb ever. You didn't want to put your head in his crotch.
No, I didn't. I didn't want Dan's balls in my face. And then I climb the ladder like I'm a cripple.
That's
like
what you gotta do. Even
the slowest. Yeah, I can reach the belt by jumping.
Even if you have the most energy.
Oh, wait. Big axe handle. Oh, no. It's an elbow drop to him while he's standing, and then he doesn't fall. It's great. Just walks around. Like, now what? Now what? I'll just twist his fucking arm 80 times. Ah, DDT. Ah, that's a good ending. I'll sit here. This match hasn't been going on forever.
I hope you guys like rest holds.
What's happening? Oh. Whoa! Oh!
Nice.
Oh, and I fall. Like, if this is the best out of five falls, why is it a ladder match?
Yeah, because it's like it has to go to five falls. Otherwise, it's just, what, if somebody just get the belt?
Yeah.
This is, watch. This is really bad right here. This is really
is this
bad.
A Hurricanrana?
Yeah, this is really bad right here. Oh, I just fucking planted him, and I'm like, can you move your legs? Are you paralyzed? Oh my god. Oh, that was awful.
I like how it's hilarious now, but if he was actually paralyzed...
Oh yeah, I would feel terrible. I would have burned this tape. But no, he's fine. I DDT'd him.
He'd come over all pissed off once a year. We're watching the tape.
No, he'd come over all pissed off, and I'd be like, ha, there's only stairs, no ramp, dude.
Lieutenant Dang?
Yeah. What do you guys think of my sunning? Should I do that again?
I think you should.
I think it's time to sunning. Oh, look at that great shot of the belt.
Fucking sunning.
I remember that in all the promo videos.
Do people even do that anymore?
Sunning? I haven't seen sunning. Has anybody out there seen sunning?
Yeah, like hockey players and stuff in high school.
You don't actually.
The whole team do that, yeah.
You can use real lemon juice. That'll work.
And, yeah, and you go out in the sun.
You just need an acid.
I use penis juice. What is this shit?
Nice.
All right, that wasn't the worst thing I've ever seen.
It was the worst thing I've ever seen.
No.
No, this is probably, it doesn't hold up over time. This is not a six-star match. This is not a one-star match. I think this is probably a negative 1.5 stars.
You realize at this time, whenever it was in the summer, like, the kids in Livingston were, like, you know, at science camp or, like, learning a second language. The kids in Nutley are doing backyard wrestling.
Yeah! And we were great at it, too. And that ladder never worked right again. My stepdad asked me, did something happen to this ladder? I'm like, no, I don't know what you're talking about.
He's
like, it won't, like, go in and out easy.
Yeah, I don't know what could have happened to her.
Burn the tape! Burn the tape!
Get rid of the evidence!
I don't know, Pops. There you go. Outsider's Edge. Oh, he's got me. He's walking around the whole ring. That hurt. Not as bad as me dropping him probably on his fucking head. Yeah, I really thought my friend was paralyzed at that point. Like, I was like... Won. I lost again.
What the hell is that? Huh, well, get the game here.
Oh, man. My character was... I put on great matches, but I always lost.
Put the IC title?
A tag title?
Here you go. Takes on the Nutley Guido.
Yeah, the Nutley Guido. Here he comes.
It's the Nutley Guido.
How you doing?
This guy's a great actor, too.
He's definitely one of your relatives.
Why is his shirt all ripped?
Because he's not like...
Hey, look, it's me! Okay.
There he is.
He's got his shirt here.
This is
Kissing the Ref.
Kissing the Ref.
Why does the Ref have a safari hat?
Because he got burned.
That's my Canada hat. No, my Canada A hat.
Fantastic.
He's Kissing the Ref.
This is a nice short match, but this is a good one, actually. I think this is probably my best match that I ever had.
Man, he really owned that stereotype.
I cracked this guinea. Oh, he just worked his ass with his hat. A Guido
hat. This commentary is hilarious.
Oh, look how hard I hit him. He's gonna feel that. There's no crowd either. Yeah.
tried to pull his keys out of his pocket.
Why is he wrestling with his keys in his pocket to begin with?
Because he's the nutley.
Oh, this is the best part right here. What I do right here, this is my finest move. Watch. Watch. Oh! Right to the fucking head.
That was a bad kick.
Right to the fucking head.
It was a great, but it was a bad
one. Got it.
The voice isn't as high anymore, Tom.
One, two. Wow, I don't believe that.
Look at Tom, jeez.
I know, right?
What the hell
are
you doing? He's fixing his hair. He's just got more.
Smiling. Always smiling.
So I was at least 10 here. Because otherwise I wouldn't have that hat.
Wow.
Wait, do you always wear a Misfit shirt to every match? That's the, at least two of the three you wore.
No, I just had a lot of them.
So you're 10, and how old are you now?
28.
Wow,
18
so
years 18 ago.
Years ago.
Holy shit, this is 18 years ago.
Yeah.
If this was a young lady, I could fuck it now.
What the hell is Raven
thinking here?
Suppose
you slipped. They could also,
That's a crazy thought, man. That was 18 fucking years ago.
Right?
Yeah.
Feeling all the effects from that kick.
You just beat the shit out of each other.
Boom.
It's the most fun, right, boy?
God, he's killing him with it.
Oh, I'm killing him.
What the hell's going on? There's a stage. Oh, my God.
Oh. Yeah, it's a good thing I ducked.
Right?
What to do now?
The Draven Trill. That's what it's called. It had a name. I don't even know if I'm going to archive this episode. This might just be a one-off. They might never get to see this. I don't want them to know my tricks and my secrets and my trade. I might be making a comeback.
Okay.
I'm coming back to wrestling.
I would do
we
it.
We did talk about doing wrestling at the Clash Bar, but that's probably not going to happen.
I trained for wrestling for about 2 months.
You know.
Yeah. You told us a lot on episode 3.
Oh, this is great. I throw this right into his nuts.
he's the Nutley Guido. He had it coming.
Right in the track pants.
Oh, yeah, and then I hit him with this dirty fucking mop. You can tell he's less than thrilled.
Who knows where that mop has been? It's yellow as shit. He's dropping him. What the hell?
That's like when Undertaker throws Mankind off the Hell in a Cell. That was our version of
that. I guess that was broken at one point.
Apparently it wasn't attached anymore.
That was the Draven Drill. What the
fuck? One, two.
The gayest pin ever.
So you just won two matches.
No, I just won this one.
Oh, that's right. You only won a fall in the other thing.
Yeah, I'm
because that match needed to go on for 2.5 hours. Wait, what time is it? I think I go to work in the morning. Oh, it's only 9:15.
My God.
Yeah, I won my belt and I hurt my back.
Oh my God. Look at him.
So yeah, that was that.
The belt?
Oh, he's got the belt right here.
Let me
see my strap. Oh.
I think that was a different one. I think we made a new. I think we made a new one.
Nice.
I have my backyard wrestling belt right here.
Cool.
Oh, and I taped over the Babysitter's Club. So that's what's at the end of this tape.
Wow.
I got the heavyweight.
You look great as a girl.
Right?
Oh, my God.
Told you.
Your range is incredible.
Told you I would have been
sexy. How did you pull up a ginger girl?
Yeah, he's got both.
This is our blue background belt?
Yeah, it was called the blue background belt because it's a blue belt.
That's fantastic.
We couldn't think of a better name. And this was the extreme title. I held this one. It was a lot of violence and fun.
Let me see.
Violence.
Oh, it's literally the Extreme Belt.
NWF Extreme Belt.
NWF.
Nice.
I was never going to be the champion. No, I'll give it back to him. Otherwise, I'm going to have to defend it.
You want to wrestle right now?
You're not going to come back.
You want to wrestle right now?
I don't know if I have your chutzpah, but I'll be the ref.
If we actually brought that back,
dude,
I want to do a documentary because I think it would be funny. There's just so much of it, and like, just it's like it's a hilarious thing. Like, it kept us away from like doing drugs and doing other shit that like all my friends that like at that time that started doing drugs.
You went to drugs.
Yeah, all my friends though at that time that did drugs were all like dead. Yeah. So it's like weird, like to think, like, oh, that's
yeah,
I was
you're doing something
time.
Creative, and
I was spending my time wrestling on mattresses with my friends, and my other friends were doing drugs, and now they're dead. Like, I was doing the right thing; they were doing the wrong thing.
If you're gonna do the documentary, you should be really over the top about it and take it way seriously.
I almost want it to be like a mockumentary.
Yeah.
But like,
I'll be number five. Like,
after 18 years, they're going back on the mat.
I like that. Yeah,
that's good.
And we get like we have to compile like mattresses and put them in the backyard and
just see like some of you guys getting ready. Somebody's got back problems. Another one's ice in their
I'm
knees.
I'm on a Tesla. Arthritis.
You like take your own Tesla before you walk out the door. You know.
We could have a whole storyline where you're like Jake the Snake and you're all drunk.
There's so much.
I'll put on a Camp Nelly shirt that probably fits.
Do you
like,
still have that shirt?
Up to like here now?
That's
I have
hilarious.
A Camp Nelly shirt. I still have that hat.
Nice. Get out.
Yeah.
That's what I mean. It would be hilarious. Like, I don't know. To do. We have so much footage.
Slow motion
shots. Probably like 20 episodes worth of like footage of us wrestling that we can definitely make into like something that. Like. In a documentary, like, you could just use it for background as to why these two guys don't really like each other. This and that, you know? Like, there's so much shit. Like, we did so much. We were discussing before the show started. When we were kids, we shot so much video. We were editing video. We were putting fucking voiceovers and, like, graphics in there and, like, the fucking... all this shit. Like, in my old age, now, that's my job, and I don't do as much of it as I did 18 years ago.
Right.
And it kind of blows my mind. Like, I was just like a kid. Like, we're a kid with, like, kids with laptops. It was like the fucking Taliban trying to shoot, like, a wrestling video. You know, like, we don't know anything about editing. We don't know anything about video. We just know what we have. We have all this gear to capture this footage, and that's what we fucking did.
We made, like, 3 fighting videos. One was called The Duel. The other was, like a kung fu video.
Yeah.
And then we did... Remember that, like, 24 ripoff, The Seeker?
We did a 24 ripoff where it's, like... But, like, for as, like, absurd as it is, it's, like, he put in all the countdown clocks and all that shit and the footage, the way, you know, how it would be, like, boom, boom, and it would show 2 shots. Like, it would zoom out of one into a box and then zoom into another that was, like, down at the left. Like,
and we did a whole trilogy of Star Wars ripoffs called Dog Wars.
With his dog.
With my dog.
His brother rotoscoped the fucking tails to be lightsabers. Like, frame by frame.
Wow.
Like, went through and fucking painted them.
Those are on YouTube somewhere. Not on my channel, but those are on YouTube. I think on Danny's channel.
All of them?
Just the first.
He's got to put them all.
Yeah. I kind of want to put them on my channel.
You should.
Yeah.
Do it.
Yeah.
Why not?
The trilogy.
Yeah.
Put the Holy Trilogy on your channel.
Exactly.
I think you should take some of this wrestling footage and do like an anti-drug commercial. In light of what you said.
Wrestling
earlier.
Is my anti-drug.
But no, we did like... Back in WWF's age, they did like these promos called played
the Creed song.
The Creed,
my
sacrifice. So like we did a few of those videos.
Okay.
Yeah, with like us talking, it's like when you enter the squared circle, you're gonna be in for a round of suffering. Like we would just like do talking over it, and like then they would cut together. Like he would like take the footage, and it's like from VHS tapes. Like it's not good footage, but like we would slow it down so it just looks like extra worse. Like somebody like reaching for the belt. It's like fucking. It's so fucking funny. But it's just like
you guys used Creed.
Yeah, because WWF used
it. Because WWF used it. Like, Dan would, like, he had all the footage, and he would just fucking be like, oh, yeah, check this out. I need this voiceover for you to say this shit. Okay. And then he'd, like, cut a video together. It was a good video. Unfortunately, it was to a Creed song.
Massive
Effect!
Yeah, I remember that.
I wanted to punch that guy in the face.
But that was wrestling at the time. That was like huge, all that shit. And like Spine Shank, all those bands. Yeah. The Beautiful People. The Beautiful People.
Yeah, Marilyn Manson. I like that song.
Spine Shank?
Yeah.
Spine Shank.
I got Spine Shanked once. It's not fun.
Are you sad at watching back at wrestling?
No. I'm just, I'm not as amped as I usually am.
Hmm. But you laughed.
I did laugh.
There was laughter.
There was laughter.
Oh, like, baby, don't get insecure on me.
You gotta do it.
That's my job. I'm supposed to be insecure about you.
See what I did there?
I like the way the role reversed.
See what I did there? He's got a second wind right now.
No,
pretty funny.
I'm on a new drug.
Okay.
And I'm not sure. The verdict is still out.
Is
I'm still not
happiness?
Fucking sleeping. I sleep maybe 6 hours a day. If I get six, I'm okay. Anything under six, I'm
gonna get about 6 hours of sleep.
You got a Tylenol PM, brother.
I think I might have
you
to. I was gonna go melatonin first.
I don't know if adults actually get more than 6 hours of sleep.
I don't know. Or no, I know people with babies don't, but.
I haven't gotten, like, if I sleep more than 6 hours, I'm dead the next day.
There's always something to do.
It blows my mind that you're a fucking adult, bro. I still think of you as this little kid in a Camp Nutley shirt with a hat on.
Yeah,
I am 28. I know. I'll be 30.
You're
20, and you could fucking throw us around like bags of shit.
He's got a full beard.
That's why I'm afraid to fucking do this documentary.
I think
Tom's gonna win.
Don't worry, I'll pull my punches.
I could
right now. I know how to take punch.
Yeah,
you're getting hurt.
Working punch?
Yeah.
You gotta bang your foot on the ground?
No, not even that. You gotta snap your hand.
Can we do a little where are they now? So where's your cousin these days? What's he do?
My cousin Phil lives in Vegas. He has two kids, married. My brother Alan is living down the shore.
Which one
now.
Was Alan? Was Alan?
Alan was the Guido.
The Guido. Nutley Guido. Okay, Alan, what does he do now?
He's working like IT stuff. He's living down the shore. He's got a house.
Cool, cool.
He has a daughter.
And then David?
David was his brother.
That's my brother.
No, I'm sorry.
Dan was my
Dan,
brother.
Dan, sorry.
Yeah. Dan is living in Florida right now.
Which part? Panhandle? Florida? West?
No,
he's by Disney.
Oh, sorry, Orlando.
Sorry,
he's 40
minutes away from Disney. They're always there.
Yeah.
They just got a new puppy.
Nice. The dog is, yeah, it's a cool dog.
Yeah. And he has a daughter.
Of all you guys, he seemed to be the best wrestler. And
that's because you just didn't see me wrestle, all right?
You didn't see us selling for like a 10-year-old.
You weren't bad, but I couldn't look at you without laughing because you were like a little kid once, and all I know of you is you're
Isn't
the grumpy guy at the
that's,
Clash.
That's
bar.
Like me opening up my life to the world. I know.
This is huge.
I wish there was more footage of me.
There is.
I don't know. Danny must have it. In his, like, remember that gray case he kept all of his like, movies in?
Was it like, magic that it had a key?
It was, like, this gray, like, leathery case, but it was not supposed to be the color gray that it was, because my mother smoked all the time in the house. So it was just, like, had that, like, yellowy look over it on top of the gray. It was just, like...
Wow.
He kept all of his, like, the things that...
All the treasures.
Yeah, the things that he made in there. Gotta be in there.
We made so much shit when we were kids. It's like almost fucking astounding to think of, like, when you have nothing else to worry about, like, you go home, there's food in the fucking pantry, like, you know, our parents all fucking worked, you know, any given time. It was like, we were kind of watching the younger kids, so it's like,
So what you're saying is you're thankful for what you have.
Oh, absolutely. You know...
That shows a really good sign of growth, Paul. Wow, we're really learning today. All the feels. All the feels.
No, it was like a fucking... I don't know. We just had nothing else to worry about when we were kids.
Yeah,
it was like... But we had all the technology to fucking record tapes and movies and this and that, so... That was like what we did. I miss that.
I'm jealous. Cause I didn't have access to that. My parents... didn't get a computer until I was at college.
Yeah.
You know, I was always the kid who didn't understand computers, you know, and would go to a computer class and be listening while everybody else was fucking around and playing Doom and shit.
or whatever.
Well, it was like you always grew up with a computer, right? Like you don't remember not having one, not having.
I do remember.
This will freak you out.
Do you? Yeah, I was my generation, my age group is right in the middle. You know, like we knew what life was before certain things, and then it became staple.
But you, I remember being at your house. You were probably 2 when you got a computer. Like I remember when you. When it came.
I know we had it at least when I was 5, because we had Windows 95.
Yeah, but
I remember not using a computer, you know?
Yeah. But you don't remember life before. Like, these guys remember life in, like, the fucking 70s and 80s. Like, there was no.
1981, there was one computer for each floor of this school. Okay, and it looked like, I mean, what we did when our class got it is we sat around and we made a picture of a llama in a cage, and it basically looked like the Atari game Adventure.
Yeah.
It was, I don't even know what kind of computer it was. It was a shit box.
We had a pet.
You had a pet?
And we saw it like once a week, maybe. Not even.
Oh, not a computer? Like, you mean a physical animal?
No, the pet was the name of the computer.
Oh, okay. I was verifying.
I've never even heard of that.
It had like a huge floppy disk like this you had to put in.
Yeah, I remember the
Oh, is that what that one song is about? We'll make great pets. We'll make great pets. To make good computers.
No, I think it's that we'll be pets for aliens.
Oh, the old Macs.
Yeah, I was going to say the old Macs with like the giant floppy disk.
The giant
disk.
5 1/4 inch.
I don't know what it is with the summertime, but we always come back to old technology on the show. Like we were talking about the Amiga last week, which I thought was the kind of the Cro-Magnon man of computers. It was it was awful, but
the first time I ever saw porn on the computer was at his house. It wasn't even on a Mac. It was on like the fucking oldest computer. It was like a 286 that was like in the basement that like we just had, and like one day somebody gave us a disc to like, yo, check this out. Like, you just run this file on it. It was like all these fucking nude pictures. Like,
so you probably saw the nude pictures that that Matthew McConaughey movie's about, right? Wasn't there a movie? No, it wasn't Matthew McConaughey.
They were just like...
There was some movie about the guys who actually put porn on the internet, and they made a fortune.
Really?
And I think it was either Matthew McConaughey.
This was before the internet, dude.
Yeah.
This was like fucking... Like, somebody gave somebody else a disc with pictures of naked
people. You mentioned this once before.
Like,
okay,
it was like the most archaic thing. Like, you had to run some program in DOS to view JPEG images that were on the disc, and they looked like shit. But it was like, holy shit.
But it was...
This is fucking dude. Naked girls.
Right.
Yeah. Like, naked broads, you know?
Yeah.
Stupid Phil and I had to go in the woods and find a Playboy that a teenager hid. You know, that was...
I knew a kid who would go to the dumpster on a certain day when they were throwing them out and quick check, and he would grab them up before they...
See what you had
there.
To do back in the day for fucking pornography?
Yeah.
See how easy it's become?
Yeah, it's just a couple of clicks and you can see midgets shitting on each other.
It's funny though.
Well, I know. I guess we know what kind of porn he watches.
I just know that that's out there. I didn't say that I watch it.
Midgets shitting on each other. 2 midgets in a cup.
Exactly.
It was funny though. Like, I think about like the porn that he and I looked at. And I had a copy of Debbie Does Dallas, which is the second most famous porn of all time.
Oh, yeah.
The first being Taboo, which is about a girl's clit in the back of her throat. And she may or may not have had to deep throat all these guys at gunpoint. Nobody knows. She got crazy and got religious and then died. Dead men don't tell any tales.
Is this like a movie or is this a porno?
No, that's a real...
It was the story behind the porno, and I think there's a movie about it.
The movie's called Taboo.
The movie was called Taboo, and the concept was that this woman... couldn't come unless she had a throat, a dick in her throat. But the woman,
what I'm asking is, did it take itself seriously as a movie?
They tried to push back.
Movies where they tried to make it a little more artistic.
Yeah. Well, they were trying to make XXX movies like a legitimate form of
art. Caligula, yeah.
And Caligula's gross, but but anyway, so the dude who played the doctor who first starts fucking her throat was up for the part in Greece that went to somebody else.
Salvinio?
The coach, right? I think he was supposed to be the coach.
And they took
the job away from him. But, like, all these, like, Hollywood actors were backing this guy and were posing with him for news stories, and then, like, everybody just left him to die.
Oh, yeah.
Poor guy.
That's what happens.
But Linda Lovelace came out later and said, I was forced at gunpoint to do these scenes. I didn't want to do this. I didn't enjoy it. I was raped. And nobody, but she joined a cult. So maybe, I don't know, people who are traumatized usually go to religion, so maybe there's teeth to that. I don't know. We live in a very he said, she said world these days, but...
It's all about the he said, she said bullshit.
Yeah.
You heard he's got a new movie with John Travolta?
Fred Durst.
He directed a new movie with John Travolta called The Fanatic, where John Travolta plays the most Nicolas Cage role of his career since Face Off.
I was going to say, it's
as like
Face-Off?
As like a fucking crazy like fan of like this action star that like gets blown off at a Comic-Con and like stalks this guy.
Holy shit.
It did so bad that it averaged, like, I think it made, like, $8,000 on its budget.
Wow.
It came out, like, this last week. But it seems like it's going to be the fucking, like, one of those
just
movies.
The classics.
You have any idea how comfortable I'd be on 8 grand right now?
One of those fucking movies that's, like, so funny and, like, it's so absurd. Like, I don't think it.
Nice.
I don't think it takes itself seriously, and I don't think the audience went into it with the right expectation.
Was it in theaters? Or
it is in theaters right now, doing absolutely horribly. It's John Travolta's fourth bomb in a row.
Wow.
Big John Travolta fan right here. His last success was Mamma Mia.
Wait, John Travolta was in that?
No, not Mamma Mia. What was that movie where you were dressed like a broad? He's in drag in it. Is it Mamma Mia? I don't know. It's some fucking musical bullshit.
I don't know.
Maybe it wasn't. I don't know.
He was great in Pulp Fiction. After that, kaput.
Alright.
No, he was good in Domestic Disturbance.
He went... Nah.
The Look Who's Talking movies
down,
weren't that bad.
He went down when he went to Scientology.
Yeah.
I think he was always in Scientology, wasn't he?
I don't think Scientology existed that until...
Scientology's existed for a very long time.
I think the 70s or the 80s.
Yeah, I think the 70s.
L. Ron Hubbard.
Yeah, L. Ron Hubbard. I think it was the
70s. Dianetics by L. Ron Hubbard.
He had his own
read
country.
Read it and give us a quarter of everything you make.
He had, like, his own little country on a boat for a while, and they were going to buy some land in South America. But I think they ended up going back to the U.S. It was, like, tax evasion or something.
Fucking Scientology.
He was, like, a failed science fiction writer.
Yeah, the Rolling Stones tax evasion.
He's not really a failed science fiction writer. I always knew him as a science fiction writer. Like, I never thought of L. Ron Hubbard as, like, oh, that guy's a failure. Like, I remember his books being around and shit. Like, my dad fucking had... definitely books by him. Like, he was into all that shit. Asimov, all those guys. Like,
did your dad ever like approach you with Scientology?
No, my dad is super fucking. He's so Christian.
I'm gonna hook you up to this thing.
No, my dad is so Christian to repress his homosexuality that he has never considered that there's any other god.
So he went the way of Little Richard.
Yeah.
Wow.
For sure.
That's
the way of Little Richard.
Well, I mean, Little Richard obviously was gay. I mean. And I'm sure, you know. I mean, how do you not be? And when there was nothing wrong with
it. I think Little Richard loved the pussy. I think he just was also a little flamboyant. I don't think he was gay.
You could be flamboyant and not gay.
I'm pretty flamboyant. I'm not gay.
Prince was flamboyant and he was married.
Yeah, but I'm sure the two of them. I don't know, the Kinsey scale. You know, the two of them. I'm sure Prince fucked some dude.
At one point.
Yeah, after he fed him pancakes.
Yeah.
I don't know what my point
fuck
is.
Fuck your
but,
couch!
No, but it's funny that, like, I don't know, I always thought that Chuck Berry got more credit for creating rock and roll than Little Richard because Chuck Berry was straight.
Remember when he put cameras in the bathroom to watch girls?
Yeah.
Who is this?
Chuck Berry. Rock and roll, great. You know, that fucking, what's that song? John Travolta. Fucking
Johnny B. Good?
Johnny B. Good, yeah.
I know that song.
Like
I saw these Michael lame old men doing that song at an open mic, and they were just sucking the life out of it. So I grabbed the mic and did the chorus, and then I dropped it. It was fucking great. But they looked like a bunch
of sassin' old men at the open mic. Fuck them.
Yeah.
Oh, you ever do the open mics? You're musical.
I've done some. I did one at Lee's Hawaiian.
Yeah.
Okay.
Did a karaoke night there.
Cool.
Did one at.
What's your go-to karaoke song, my friend? Is it a 90s song? Because you're a 90s guy?
It's actually probably... I mean, it used to be Kryptonite by Three Doors Down.
Okay.
But then I...
If I go crazy... Yeah, that's a good... It's an easy range.
This kid's been singing that since he's like a little kid.
Yeah.
But
now I go towards like Billy Joel or Queen.
Okay. Wow.
Yeah, this motherfucker can sing.
Yeah, what Queen song?
Well, probably Bohemian Rhapsody, but
wow.
Don't Stop Me Now as well.
Don't Stop Me Now.
Yeah, this kid could sing, dude.
Cool.
He's got like perfect pitch and shit.
No, really? Sure.
He don't know it, but he does.
I partake in the singings.
He is a talent whisperer. This guy. So if
he helped me learn how to record shit on my computer and stuff.
Back in the day.
Yeah.
Yeah, we recorded a good song called "Drunk Bitch."
Yeah.
Nice.
Drunk bitch, she's on the floor. What is it? On the floor?
Ground.
Or on the ground. Yeah, drunk bitch, no fun to have around. Alky, she's such a mess. I think she's had enough.
Yeah, we wrote a pretty good song, man. In there.
That's great.
We did a cover of Eleanor Rigby by the Beatles.
Oh, yeah, I forgot about that.
I think I have that on my iPod.
Yeah, we did some shit, like, back in the day. Like, we were always doing something. It was never fucking just...
I haven't been able to record anything in years. I recorded one song, which is actually on my channel, called Shooting Star. Because, alright, I was working at ShopRite, and that Taylor Swift song came on where she's like, I'm wishing on a wishing star or something like that.
Yeah.
And I'm like, no, you don't say wishing star. It's not a wishing star. It's a shooting star. You wish on shooting stars. So, like, in my head, I'm like, I'm wishing on a shooting star. So I made that into a song. And I made a whole song out of that. And
you just described my entire existence. I think of songs every day. I got like 50,000 files on my phone.
I made a full song out of that. It was the best song I've ever recorded, even, like, I mean, like, quality-wise.
Uh-huh.
Writer's block ever since.
Well, look, every phone has a recorder. You get a melody, just sing it. Even if it's shit.
I have like 10 of those on my phone, but it's like, I go to sit down and write lyrics, and I write like a chorus, and I can't write anything else.
You're forcing it. You can't force it.
It doesn't matter if I force it or not. I just can't write anything.
I don't know, dude. What you need to do is get inspired and work on yourself. Something will come.
Yeah, I've tried.
The problem is sometimes, if life is good, it's hard to write songs. Do you find that?
Most of my songs...
Is it hard to write prose, like, if you're in a good place?
I mean, it depends on the kind of prose that you write. If you're writing, like, tortured crime novels, it may be. But if you're writing, like, fantastical stuff, like J.K. Rowling or something, then, you know, that's just coming off your imagination. Actually, for that kind of stuff, it's probably better if your life is pretty settled, because then you have the time to invest in it.
Thing was, I get what you're saying. I always wrote my best songs were always out of anger until I was in the disasters and I wrote Pig Pick with Ann, because it was the first time we did a song that had no agenda. It was about the love of something, my love of eating and pork and making silly and double entendre, like AC/DC did in Big Balls, which was always one of my favorite songs. There's still like the theatrics, but
yeah,
it used to always be
balls.
Like when I wrote Drama Queen for the Adam beat, it was about this chick I worked with named Ginny. You'd probably fuck her. You definitely would. But she was such a drama queen. Like, everything was a problem. And so, like, every day is a different scene. She's a drama queen. But now I realize I've become... You live long enough, you become the villain. I think I am a drama queen now. So I think I need to rewrite the song. No, I used to be really low-key.
You know how many songs I wrote where I'm like, oh, wow, this song is, like, very self-referential without it being self-referential. You know, like, I think I'm writing about something else, but it's like, oh, yeah, if I look at myself objectively... You know, like, I could do that. Like,
My therapist told me that the things you hate in people are the things you hate in yourself, in most cases.
Well, now I find that since my life is pretty good, like, I have a good job, and, you know, okay, my life's not really a struggle right now. Like, I'll say that. Like, I'm probably the most comfortable I've been in a long time. Like, I write songs about the fucking mailman, and, like...
You're a different end.
Like, and, like, I wonder if my neighbor is dead, and, like, these weird songs where I'm like, it's just, like, it's kind of a joke, but it works as, like, a punk song, so that's sort of just what I wrote. Like, I wrote all these weird songs.
Songs you could never, ever shout anyone.
No, I shout everyone. I play them all the time, and people like them, which is, like, funny, but it's, like... That's the thing. I would think to never show anyone that, but when I play it and, like, my friend's like, whoa, that's fucking funny. Like, you should make... I was just joking around one day because my friend hadn't seen his neighbor in, like, years. So I was, like, messing around on an acoustic guitar. He's like, you should make that a song. Like, that's catchy. Like, I wonder if my neighbor is dead.
Yeah.
It's like, okay. I have, like, five friends that are fucking mailmen. And it's like, they all complain about the same shit. Like, if I don't fill in my numbers on this little machine. They're going to fucking ring me up. Oh, I got to be here at this time and this and that. Like, they all have, like, this fucking agenda that the Postal Service is just like, you are my puppets.
Back in the day, you'd see postmen, like, taking, like, two-hour lunches. And
going postal from coast to coastal?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, I forgot about that. Yeah. The mailman.
Yeah.
We had a horrible mailman when I was a child.
Oh, yeah? Did he molest somebody?
No. No.
He would just walk up to the lawn with the mail like this. Like, oh, yeah, I got your mail. And rather than go to your mailbox like a normal person, he would just go...
we would come to that, like the door, and they would just be on the ground.
Yeah, it's like, oh, we got to take the mailbox
right there.
Off the floor. And he did that to every house. Like, I remember watching out the window, he would just be like, walk up to the next house. Just fling the shit. He was an asshole.
I kind of like him, though.
No, you know what? He's my asshole of the week. That former mailman is my asshole of the week. He was horrible, and I believe that our parents collectively got him fired.
Good.
Nice.
Yeah, because he was a dick.
If not collectively, definitely dead.
Yeah, definitely his mom. She's a complainer. Who's your asshole of the week? Anybody?
All right, I'll take this one. So I went to the acoustic night on Thursday, because... Allie's been doing acoustic songs with Lou, so I was videoing it for him. And I was sitting down in the corner seat where I usually sit, and I was having a chat with Bob. And I noticed throughout the night there was this heavyset blonde woman who was, like, talking too loudly about how great The Clash Bar is, and, ooh, I need to find out what that movie is. And I'm sure you've heard that dreck over the years. But anyway, I talk to Bob, and I'm like, so, hey, would you be interested in interviewing? Sometimes Bob gets a little shy and coy, and he's all like, no, why are you interviewing me? So this woman decides to fucking intervene and butt in, and she's like, what are you doing to my Bob? And I went, I don't fucking know you, but he's nobody's Bob but Alyssa's. But then, so then I was like, he's like, wait, what interview? I'm like, call the contempt. I was like, Paul and I want to interview you. I was like, oh, no, wow. So plan B is you're going to have to talk to him. But, like, my whole mojo got flipped. And they were buying a lot of drinks, so of course Bob went over to them and did a shot with them. That's his that's his move.
She cock blocked you.
She totally cock blocked.
She Bob blocked you.
She Bob blocked you.
Me. But like, I don't know, like, I was in a good place until she annoyed me, and I just turned to her and I said, I don't fucking know you. And I'm usually not like that. It was weird. It's really weird. Out of body.
She's hanging out with me.
No.
Yeah.
You think?
Yeah, that's how I am. You should have been videotaping when I was driving, because that's the funniest shit ever.
Yeah.
Look at this fucking jerk off. I just say, oh, this fucking
jerk. No, he was saying, yeah.
I'm the funniest fucking person. He's like, I don't know why I'm not videotaping this. I'm like, yeah, I don't know why you're not either, dick.
We were at the Necropolis store. We were heading home, and my GPS, for some reason... Google Maps never comes up fast enough, and then you hit start 100 times and it still doesn't load. It just takes its fucking time. I guess it's the satellites or whatever. But then he's like, I guess we just go over the Passaic River. I don't know, we might die. And then we go over this little bridge, and of course it was the right way. 21 was right there. We just hopped right on. But nah, he was swearing and cursing, and he made a comment about, I have to make a right, and we actually made a right and went up the street by Eastwood College and turned around there, and then later I pulled out of the parking spot. I'm used to parking down there and just taking that one road over Kingsland and behind the La Quinta. But anyway, long story short, you cannot make a left out of this parking lot in this building at rush hour. And I left here at what, 5:05?
You're not making a left.
I'm not making a left.
You could go up the street, you'll see the fucking cars all the way up to Washington Avenue.
It's
joke.
Fucking nuts. You have to make a right and turn around. Like, I thought about going to the shop right since I was heading that way, but I was so funny. All right, one quick comment. I was at the Belleville shop right doing a. What's that?
Make it quick.
I was at the Belleville ShopRite doing a demo, and then I noticed the liquor store in that little weird mini mall. I don't know if it's a mall. It's a liquor store, a jewelry store, and the ShopRite. That's it. And then the Shop at Home shit. I guess some store closed down, and then the Shop at Home just moved in there. But they had comics, so I was like, oh. So I found a couple Image first issues. I'm just gonna kind of hold on to, but they're only a buck a piece. But it's weird because I wanted to get Alana a little bottle of vodka for her birthday gift that I made,
and I needed one, and they were like, it's a $5 minimum. I was like, oh, I'll just buy comics. So that was kind of weird.
Yeah, that's
that
odd.
A liquor store is selling comics in the hallway of the mall? I don't know. It's not even a mall.
Take it where you can get it, man.
Yeah. Anyway, so that's my story. Who's your asshole of the week, Phil?
I was pulling into my building today. We've got like a long driveway, and some young rascal decided to park right in the middle of the driveway, right near the edge of the street. You know, I live on a busy street, so I tried to turn in, and then all I see is trunk. Then I gotta like rearrange myself and try to skimmy past me while he's in his phone. So I just passed his car real slow, and like our mirrors like nearly scratched each other, and I just looked at him the whole time, and he just looked up and his eyes were big as saucers, and then he finally pulled over. So fuck that guy. That's my asshole.
I think people need to be more self-aware in this universe. Or
but I guess just to see like a guy like just fucking staring at you as he's slowly almost scratching your car, like
yeah, he's lucky you're not throwing a lit cigarette on his head. That's
you're
my
the
favorite.
Sweetest man alive. How do you have an asshole of the week?
So I did not know that there was an asshole of the week type thing.
But who's your hero of the week?
So
you can do it either.
Or is it
so?
Sorry.
No. I'll go. I didn't really deal with a lot of people this week.
Okay.
Yeah. My life basically consists of work.
Yeah.
I did go to.
Wait, what do you do for a living?
Tech support. I work with databases mostly.
Okay.
Computer stuff.
Yeah. So I would probably say that I am the asshole of the week for me, because
we've had that
out of everybody that I've talked to all week, I'm probably the biggest asshole.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow, but you're so nice.
I know.
Aww. We gotta have you back. We gotta do a fucking screening of all of our like short fellas. Like, we'll fucking find the duel where he and his brother fight and shoot guns at each other.
Nice.
Just, yeah.
I want to see the Daydream Believer video.
The Daydream Believer.
Sure, I have this, yeah.
Yeah,
you guys leave.
I could cue that up right now.
Nice.
On that note, we're not even going to fucking leave you with the usual.
The outro.
The outro. I think we're going to leave you with this lovely version of Daydream Believer.
Ooh.
Got to make sure that the sound.
Oh, we're going to end with it. That's great.
Yeah.
Can't wait.
Yeah, I think I could do it.
Cheer up, sleep.
And my computer didn't just shit the bed, which it looks like it kind of.
Oh,
did.
No!
I don't know.
Oh, no.
I tried to move something off of one screen to the other, and there it goes.
Oh, nice. Oh.
Hey, it's Bob.
Live!
Bob Clash, my background. We will get him on this show.
I don't think it's going to happen, dude. Unless you're the Bob Whisperer.
Oh, I am absolutely the fucking Bob Whisperer.
I think Paul, like, thinks, like, my two dads, and one of them is Bob, and the other one is Ronnie Skull. That would be a great
Ronnie
sitcom.
Skull is just a less successful
what the hell?
Bob.
How do I get to your YouTube? I gotta spell out 90s?
The 90s guys, yes.
Yeah, I hope Ronnie never hears that. He doesn't have a computer.
Yes, he does!
It's got dust on it.
And even if he wanted to beat me up, he doesn't ever ride here to beat me up. I really do want Ron.
Nine
times. I have a lot of questions, like geek out questions, like,
oh, there we go.
Do you want to play CBs? How did that go? You know, stuff like that.
Yeah, you know. That would be great.
And he'd be a great guy to talk about the old school punk, like the CB days.
Just,
are
just
we
a search.
On?
We should have people
call
or something.
Just use a search. Just type in.
Oh yeah, we're still.
Daydream.
Hello. Is there anybody out there? Did you turn the show on?
They're one person. So
it's probably Lindsay. Hi, Lindsay. Thanks for coming over the other day. Your pie was delicious.
Oh wow.
I don't know if we can hear it though.
Oh no, we'll be able to hear it.
Instead of joint, you know, marijuana.
Hold on, I'm gonna just.
It's you, but like a mini you. It's like looking at those baby Ewoks in Empire Strikes Back, and then you see the full grown one. And that's
it. Yeah, it's kind of trippy, right?
Let me just make it so that here's a grown man giving a child drugs.
It's normal behavior.
Yeah, try this.
It's good. Good.
It's good. Can they hear it?
Yeah, they can hear it.
Okay.
It's obviously lit.
Oh wow. You guys do effects I don't even touch.
Yeah, we don't fuck around.
Put the swipe there.
It gets better.
One hit, huh?
Creepy as fuck.
Must have been dust in that fucking thing.
Wow.
We got a fucking green screen, dude.
Nice. This is supposed to be an anti-drug commercial. You're making drugs look awesome.
Yeah, I know, right? Is that a bottle of wine next to you?
It looks so happy. This is converting in hell.
And happy about it, apparently.
This is fine.
We're like, yeah, just jump in front of this screen.
Fine.
This just seems like a sequence in a movie where the character tries drugs and
yeah.
The montage of
when he finds out they're fantastic.
Yeah.
That was Mr. Blind. Except for that stuff that'll tell you.
Where the fuck did we even find these pictures?
I know, right?
What is that? Is that Animal Farm?
Look at Schwarzenegger in like a Japanese energy drink commercial.
That's like a sheet on the lawn.
Oh, look at this little Davy Jones dance.
Nice.
The fucking robot!
I know, right? That's
a high five from like 10 years ago.
Yeah, really. And we're farts.
Look at Mace's poor kids and jump in front of this green screen and do it every
Oh my god, you have no, you were probably making his day. He probably wanted to be with the big kids.
Doesn't it start to slow down?
Later.
This is what happens when you give kids a green screen.
Yeah, really.
Those great effects.
Nice.
I forgot about that! Why did you guys bury the lead? We should have led with this.
Jesus.
Wait, there's Paul.
Oh,
so you can tell it's me because I have a skull on the shirt.
Yeah. Oh, you're going to sit down now.
Should have ended it by murdering. We were testing the green screen.
This is literally the green screen testing video.
That's hilarious.
Yeah, lay on this thing. We're gonna make you fly.
You can visibly see the square around me. The rectangle.
I don't know why we don't end every episode with this video.
And on that note, we're out of here.
We hope you enjoyed our presentation of Cult of Contempt Podcast. If you have any questions or comments, or want to hear your band on the show, just write us at cultofcontemptpodcast@gmail.com. If you'd like to see back episodes of the show, youtube.com/plan10studios, cultofcontempt.org, or right here on Facebook, Cult of Contempt Network. Even check us out on Instagram, @cultofcontemptpodcast. You want to reach Paul? It's @PaulMald on Twitter and Instagram, and Paul of the Living Dead on Facebook.com. Phil Perry, the writer, on Instagram, and his Facebook fan page, @PhilPerryTheWriter. I'm Jim Cook at Jim Cook on Facebook or Jim Cook Voice Actor on Facebook. You want to get a hold of me directly, jcookvoice@yahoo.com. On behalf of Paul and Phil, I want to thank you for listening. We'll see you next week at 8:15. I'm Jim Cook. Transmission out.
Stay by for contact.
We hope you enjoyed our presentation of Cult of Contempt Podcast. If you have any questions or comments, or want to hear your band on the show, just write us at cultofcontemptpodcast@gmail.com. If you'd like to see back episodes of the show, youtube.com/plan10studios, cultofcontempt.org, or right here on Facebook, Cult of Contempt Network. Even check us out on Instagram, @cultofcontemptpodcast. You want to reach Paul? It's @PaulMald on Twitter and Instagram, and Paul of the Living Dead on Facebook.com. Phil Perry, the writer, on Instagram, and his Facebook fan page, @PhilPerryTheWriter. I'm Jim Cook at Jim Cook on Facebook or Jim Cook Voice Actor on Facebook. You want to get a hold of me directly?